And the ratio.
Yeah. And it is equal to.
Is equal to.
Indeed, if we take a square, well, first of all, we can notice that the problem can be solved for a square because of projection. But after talking about the square, we can anyway consider the parallelogram in general case, yes? For studying purposes for education. In a square, obviously, all these blue lines meet at the center, yes?
Yes.
And the vertices of this octagon is a Westmeyer, the vertices of the octagon lie on these blue lines. They also, this, because black lines meet on the blue lines. These two are the octagons. So, the blue line divides the octagon into eight pieces. And all these triangles are congruent.
Yes.
In a square because of the symmetries. Okay. Reflect. So it suffices to find that the area of this triangle. And we will find the area of the octagon. So to find the area of the green triangle, we can compare it to this big green triangle. So whatever theory which allows us to find the ratio of the areas, these two triangles have what in common? One sixth. So in the entire square, it's also one sixth. Yes.
As for the general case, for the parallel, well, in fact, it is not really necessary to talk about the square. Of course, with the square, it's easy. For example, obviously, the triangles are congruent and so on. But if you take even the parallel, then these lines grow, well, the blue lines, meet at the center of anybody. Diagonals meet here and midline meet here. And then we will do this piece of an octagon here in a parallelogram. So everything I said will be true for this without knowing that it is a square, just using for a parallelogram this is one half, this is one third. And same would be for the other. So of course it is more pleasant to deal with the square. Более приятно иметь дело с квадратом. Но в данном случае это существенно, в общем-то, не помогает. То же самое, что можно сделать для квадрата. Ничего такого специфического именно для квадрата.